Welcome back to the channel where we continue along in Power BI. And today we're going to learn one new skill in Power BI. We're going to take a look at the new card visual and show you how to apply conditional formatting on one of the cells in the card. And then we're going to show you how it interacts when you pull in a slicer. And we're going to use the rules for the conditional formatting. So it's the new card visual. The one skill we're going to learn is the conditional formatting and show you how you can use rules to set up some of the slicers and filter down and see quickly on the visual how it's performing as a KPI. Let's go to Power BI. Back in Power BI, and today we're going to learn one new skill. We're going to do some conditional formatting in the new card. We are also going to create that card, add an accent, and then do some conditional formatting. So the first thing we're going to do is in Power BI, we are going to add some data and use the sample data set for the financials. So if you've never tried some of the different sample data sets you can do and work with Power BI, remember the best way to get to know Power BI is just to work with different data sets and learn the data and then start to build out your DAX functions and your measures. So you're gonna load your sample data, and we are gonna load from the sample data set the financials table. And it's a basic table. We're gonna hit the transform data button. First thing you always wanna do when you go inside Power Query is always check out the data types. Make sure that everything okay. So we have a data set here with country, product, discount band, and we are going to really not change anything. We have text for our main, for the numbers. We do have a decimal number for the sales. We have a profit number, which is set up as a decimal number. Then we have the date, the month number, and the month name. The year is set up as a whole number. So we are going to make no changes to this data set since it's cleaned and it is a sample data set from Power BI. So all we're going to do next is hit close and apply. We're going to make three different measures inside Power BI once the data loads. And it's got 700 rows. Our data has been imported. And the first measure is going to be sales. So we're going to work with sales, and the DAX syntax is going to be the name of the measure. Then we're going to use the sum, and now we get, it's asking for a column name. Now in financials, we have gross sales, which is the amount after the discount. And then we have the sales column. So we're going to go to financial sales. And then we're going to close off that formula. And so it's the sum of the column financial sales. So that's our first measure. Then we are going to format that as currency with zero decimals. So measure number one is done. The second thing, as we continue along with our conditional formatting example, is we're going to create a measure called total profit. And total profit, name of the measure, the syntax is, again, using the sum function, which always use your IntelliSense if you're new to DAX and Power BI. It's asking for a column name in the blue. So we are going to now, this time, go to financials and look for the profit. And the profit is going to be the total profit summed up. So we're going to go to the profit column, and then we're going to close out the DAX syntax with the right parenthesis. So now we have total profit, and we are going to format this as a currency, and we are going to put zero decimals. And if you format your DAX right away, then that way every time you use the measure, it will automatically go into that formatting. The third and final measure we are going to use for this example is gross margin. And this is an example of nesting your measures. And gross margin is going to use the divide function. And we're going to divide And again, use your IntelliSense. It's asking for a numerator and a denominator. And we're going to take the two existing measures. We're going to nest these measures inside this gross margin. So the numerator is going to be total profit, and then it's a comma, and then the denominator highlights in blue, and the denominator is going to be sales. So we're going to nest these two measures inside another measure. So once we close that off, we have our gross margin, and we are going to format this as a percentage, and we are going to go to zero decimals. So we've created three measures from the sample data set. We've got gross margin, we've got sales, and we've got total profit, and they're all in the financials table. So now in this example, we are going to use the new card measure. So in the visual gallery, we are going to scroll down and you'll see the gauge card and KPI, and you see the new card visual. So we will select that. And now this visual allows for multiple cards inside one visual. So now we're going to add our three new measures that we created. The first one is sales. Then we are going to add the total profit. And the third measure we're going to add is gross margin. New card visual has been created, and we've added the three data types. We've got sales, total margin, and gross margin. And this new card visual allows for a lot more flexibility, and you can also build out these cards. And we're going to show you how to use some conditional formatting. So the first thing we're going to do is size up this card, and we're going to go with this. And now we are going to bring in another slicer. And the slicer is going to be the country. So we have our country and we have our card visual. The first thing we are going to do with this card visual, as you start to build it out, you're going to see some of the different options. You have the size and the style. It does allow for a title. And then for the shape, you've got either the rectangle shape. You can also use the rounded rectangle. And a third option is the snip tab on the top. So it snips that top corner. We're going to leave it as the rounded rectangle for this example. So that's the shape options. Then for the callout, you can either call out each of the different values in the card, which we have sales, total profit, and gross margin. And you can then, we are going to change all of them to 40 point. So that's going to make them smaller. So that is all we're going to change with the values. The labels you can turn on or off. We need to have the labels on, so we'll leave those on. And then you start to get into your actual cards, which is the bottom of the visual option. So the cards is where we're going to focus on for this one. And then there's also an accent bar at the bottom. So for all of these, we're going to turn the accent bar on and we're going to change the color to this deep purple. And then we're going to turn off the border. So what that does when you click on it, it adds that accent to the left-hand side of the visual. And now we are going to work on the conditional formatting, but we only want to format one portion of the card. So on the callout, we are going to choose gross margin to apply these settings to. So what we are going to do now with the card is we're going to work on the fill. And this allows us to change the, rather than the series, we are going to apply to the gross margin. And we're going to hit this little FX button. And the FX button is the conditional formatting. And we are now going to choose from the format style. And what we are going to choose is rules. You can choose a gradient, a rules, or a field value. So the rules is going to be on the gross margin field. And now you start to build out your rules. So the first one is greater than and equal to the minimum. And we are going to set up a rule that if it's less than, and you always have to start off with your rules going in order. So if it's less than 0.15%, that is going to be a warning sign. So we're going to put that in red. Then we're going to add a second rule that if it's greater than or equal to, if it's greater than 0.15 and less than the max, then we're going to have that be a positive indicator. So we're going to use the gold. So this rule is set up so that if the value is greater than the minimum or equal to, which in this case, the lowest percentage you could have would be zero, and then less than 0.15. So 0.14 would come out in red. And then if it's greater than 0.15, it would be gold. So that's going to set up the rule. So overall, the gross margin, we want to be 14%. So that is in red because it's less than 15%. Now, when you go individually on the filters, Canada has 14%, France has 16%, so it conditionally changes to the gold. Germany has 16% with 4 million in profit. Mexico is 3 million in profit, but only a gross margin of 14%. And the United States has 12%, which is less than 15%. So that, again, right away on this conditional formatting, if somebody is using this report, they see that France and Germany are both okay, and we need to work on the gross margin overall for Canada and for Mexico and for the United States of America. So that is the conditional formatting in the new card using the new rules. Remember, with the rules you set up, and if you go back to that, when you click on the FX button, you see your rules on the color series. And you can choose whatever colors. You can also use numbers, and you can use other formats. But in this format, we used the rules, and we used percentages on the Learn One New Skill in Power BI. That is a look at conditional formatting on the new card feature in Power BI that came out in June of 2023.